What's up, everybody? Glorious Monday, number 100, everybody. 100. Figured I'd come in with a silly intro, something different. Camera's facing me. So, yeah, man. 100, man. Never thought. Thank you, sir. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Never thought I'd make it to the big 100, but I did. I thank you guys for the support along the way. This video feels different. Maybe because I'm here. Shout out to Brian Dawkins, by the way. I was slinging him across the room. Have so many Dawkins base cards, so I figured I'd throw some humor into it and throw some Dawkins at the camera. You know what I mean? Just throw some at the camera, baby. Yeah! So, anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. Flores, what's up, boy? What's up, what's up, what's up? Fresh on the planes from the Nationals. Wish I could have been there this year. Hey, what's going on, Fess? Like I said, I wish I could have been there this year. Different circumstances happened where I couldn't. Mama! Hey, baby! Mwah! I couldn't make it. Circumstances, life. But Lars Willing, if indeed they do have the Atlantic City show and show out at Nationals Atlantic City, baby. Make it rain cards on them. Make it rain on them, baby. Just having a good time. Woo! So, anyway, like I said, I thank you guys for all the support. Feel I should have more support, but you guys have been supporting me through the ups, the downs, and all the rounds, man. So, thank you guys. Mail Day 100. I was able to share this with y'all. I appreciate you guys so much, man. Those that... We should be back. My internet don't want me to be great tonight, son of a bitch. But it's all good. It's all good. It's always. Yeah, man, I don't know what's going on, man. I'm showing full internet capacity over here, man. And it just does not want to work right with me for some odd reason. There's not a whole lot of devices on. It was the intro, man. If I didn't do the intro, it would have been a great evening. I promise you. I can almost guarantee it. I'm just going to jump in some settings real fast and see if there's something I can do to kind of adjust this a little bit. Hopefully we can stay together. We can be together through the weather, through the good and the bad and the sad. All right, let's see if this helps a little bit. I kind of turned down the internet on here a little bit. You guys let me know what's going on. It looks like we're good to go. Should be good, damn it. Like I said, the damn internet's trying to player hate on the player because he came in with a bomb ass intro, and yeah, they hating on me right now, but we should be good. It sucks because I lost so much time in this mofo dealing with the damn internet, so we should be good. I'm gonna show a card to tell me if you're good. You can see it, right? Are we good? I'm hyped, man, but the internet's slowing me down. Are we good? Can we see that? Huh? Can we see it? Can we see it? Huh? Can you see it? All right, we're good. We're good. I probably ran some people away with my trashy-ass internet. I seen Mama Smith had it roll out, so I know she's not here, but see you later, Mama Smith. Love you long time. But yeah, All right, so we're going to go ahead and get into this, man. Sorry for all the technical difficulties. This is like the second week that I had the difficulties. Not understanding why, but I turned down the buffer a little bit. I don't know if it's something with the Streamlab that I'm using. For some reason, the settings was like hyped all the way up, so I turned them down, and it looks like that the internet's holding better. So I don't know, man. Just some configurations within the app, man. Like I said, the app updated, and you know, I know my internet's not that bad. Like, I can game all night long and don't have no problem. So, there's no reason why I can't stream. All right, so let's get into this. I got stacks on stacks on stacks on stacks to share with you guys. This whole pile here, I've been getting stuff from everywhere. We're talking eBay. We're talking player breaks. We're talking team player breaks, PYT, pick your team breaks. So this whole pile here has been, miscellaneous stuff I've been getting. I got some goodies in here from Mr. Eloy Flores, some stuff that I purchased off him. So we're just going to go through it. And so far, everyone's in here tonight. I've put you guys down, your names down on a card. Like I said, this is the 100th mail day, and I will be doing a random giveaway to whoever name is drawn. If your name is drawn, there's some people that I got stuff I'm already getting stuff for, but I will add more stuff to your PC. I didn't go to Nationals, so I was not able to get any cards, any boxes. So when I randomize your name, if you're on the top and you're on the bottom, I'll be getting some stuff for your PC, especially for you. Like I said, it's not nothing that I have in the ordinary. Like I said, I got some packages that I need to go out. I'm just waiting for a few items to come in. But if you're one of those people and your name is drawn, then I'll make sure I add some more stuff to your pile. I just want to thank you guys again and again and again and again. I know I'm rambling, man, but to make 100 videos and have the support from you guys, it's like fucking paradise. So thank you guys so much for the love and the support and all that other shit. Thank you so damn much. Okay. But all right, we're going to share some cards that I picked up. These cards, these first set of cards I picked up from Mr. Eloy Flores. He got these from someone that, you know, someone was selling cards. He bought them and, you know, I took them off his hands. So we have the Carson Wentz element. This picture looks great, man. I don't know if it's just my camera or what, but the damn quality looks a whole lot better than what it did last week for some reason. Shout out to Streamlab if they finally updated the shit like it's supposed to. We have the rookie Jalen Hurts out of Legacy last year. All these cards are numbered, by the way. I'm not going to really get into the numbers. I'm already behind in this video from all the damn technical difficulties. But this is another Jalen Hurts under the lights. I think this was numbered to 50, if I had to guess. It was numbered to 100, so I was completely wrong on that. We got some more Jalen Hurts action out of Phoenix. We have the thank you, Yeti. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We have the rising of rookie. So rookie rising, rising rookie. Either way you want to put it, he's a rising star. Got some Jay Rigor, however you want to say that. I like saying it all kinds of different ways. As you can see, this is numbered to 799. Got some short print action of Mr. Miles Sanders. This is last year's Legacy, I believe. Last year's Legacy. So this will be his rookie card, and it is number 25. We have some more Jalen Rigor. This is a limited print to 150. We have some more Miles Sanders, which is number 49, which he's having a good training camp so far, man. And we have the Quez Watkins out of 50. So that's pretty much some pickups I picked up from Mr. Eloy Flores. Thank you, Mr. Eloy. I think you're probably not in here because you're on your plane. But thank you for that stuff there. This upcoming stuff is some stuff that I had gotten a player break. And I got in a PYT. I'm just going to show it all. It's too much to separate. Got some more stuff I got from Eloy. I'll show that stuff here in a little bit. But I was in a PYT break, actually with Eloy, over at, I think it's P, P, PYP. Somebody. Well, somebody he knows. I jumped in the Elite Break. Cost me about, I think, $60. I think it was 12 boxes or 6. Not sure. But we're going to start off with this year's rookie on deck of Mr. Devontae Smith, which is having a excellent training camp, man. He is, like, kicking ass in training camp, man. We have the Jamie Newman at a $9.99, which is no longer an Eagle, man. So I don't know what his future is going to be. I heard he was pretty good. We just didn't have room on our depth chart for him. We brought in some amazing players, man. So they rated us to be at the bottom, but now with some of the moves we made, we're actually trending up. So that's always a good thing. We have some Kenneth Gainwell. Those that are not too familiar with the Eagles, man, this is actually Fletcher Cox's cousin. They are family members. They had several pictures taken together during the training camp. As you see, I just moved Brian Dawkins out the way, and I have my man Fletcher Cox up there, man. Shout out to Alloy on the supplies. Last time I had him up here in the last video, I didn't have the 8x10 top loader and sleeve. I have it now, so it is protected, just like my man B Dawk is. All right, moving down the line, we have some rookie elitist, which is pretty smooth looking card. You can actually feel the words. You can actually see the wording on the back. So it actually has a nice texture to it. Pretty dope card, man. I was not fortunate enough to get the gold. These things are numbered, but this one unfortunately is not. We have some more Devontae Smith. This is out of 99. This is the purple. I do not have much of his stuff. I have not been chasing his stuff because he's so damn expensive. So I just been pretty much focusing on my main PC and my side PC. But I felt a little froggy, so I jumped in this player break. Team break. This is the Jalen Hurts Aspirations out of 98. Only thing I don't like about Elite, they have some weird numbering. This is the die cut. But the numbering is weird, man. They got numbers to 99 and 899 and 750 and, as you see, 98. Like, why have a card out of 98 instead of just having it out of 99? I would love to research that and figure out what the hell they were smoking when they did the numbering. But that's just what it is. We got some dual threats. We got some Jalen Hurts action again. This is the... like, I guess you would say it's more like an insert parallel. But this is a dope card. I like the way this card's set up. It's numbered out of 75, so it is a short print. I don't think so, man. I have to check that out, man. But I don't think so. I really don't. But I'm going to have to look into that. So, last two cards from that break, we have the Miles Sanders. Out of 49, I don't know exactly what they call this. I just call this, like, the orange bubbly card because it looks like bubbles. It looked like disco. Something, you know, you want to go get your party on and, you know, disco light, crazy scenes, whatever. But, yeah, solid card for Miles Sanders. There's not a whole lot of Miles Sanders stuff out there because his rookie year is over. And we do have the Miles Sanders die cut out of 24. So, not bad, man. Wish I would have got some ink in that break, but I did not. Moving on. These cards I'm showing you are some cards that I've got from Alloy. These cards, I think, been sitting for a long time. And there's been some that he picked up along the way. As him going to these card shows and stuff he's into. This is one. This is a Mike Williams Galaxy gear. I'm not exactly sure if I paid him for this or he sent this. Because this card was actually sitting with him for a while. This is a short print 50. So, if I pay for it, shout out to me. If you give it to me, shout out to you, brother. I think this come out the collection box, which he hasn't did a collection box in God knows when. But this is the Paul Pierce Mission Accomplished, which is Paul Pierce is one of my favorite Celtics. I also like Mr. Rajon Rondo. And I liked, you know, Ray Allen when he was there. But, you know, Ray Allen betrayed us and went and got a ring with the Miami boys. I can't be mad at him. But, you know, I wish he would have stayed in Boston and got and helped us get another ring. So, we got a throwback passing leaders. Mr. Jaws over there. Big Cat got Mr. Bert Grossman. I honestly don't know who he is. I'm not going to lie. This is something that came out of the collection box that L. Lloyd threw in. We have the Reggie White, baby. I have a few of these. I never get tired of getting too many Reggie Whites. This is 1 out of 10. I think this is actually one I needed. I think I have the majority of these. He has a set out of 10. And he has a set out of 12 as well. And I think this is actually one of the ones I actually needed. We got a bunch of rookie Brian Dawkins. Can't get enough of the Dawkins. I don't give a damn if I have 8,000 doubles of rookie cards of Dawkins. It's going to be what it's going to be. And with that said, these are my favorite rookie cards, man. And thank you, Eloy, for that. I have the Freshman Finest with the protective seal still on these, man. I always wanted to pull one seal off. All my Dawkins cards that are like this are sealed. So I'm actually going to pull the protective seal off of one of these. Why? I don't actually, you know what? I'm not even going to bother. I'm just going to leave it the way it is. See, I always got to be messing with shit. So we're just going to leave it alone. But I will get these in the top loader. And these will go in the Dawk box. Got some breaking news with the Dawkins too, man. I'll talk about that a little bit as I get there. So, all right, next we got another Dawkins card. This is not a rookie. This is like year 1997. This is the second year in. And then we have a bunch of inserts of Mr. Brian Dawkins from Eloy Flores, along with some others. And we got the Brandon Graham, the red, white, and blue. All right, so lastly, before we get into the stack that I put some money into, you know, where all the juice is. You know, I always hit y'all with the heavy stuff, the light stuff, and then I get heavy. And I got some good stuff in here, man. It's not going to be nowhere good as last week's mail day, but it's going to be some fire in there. So I did get in a break with Snods, his Luminance break. And I had one with Eloy too, which I tanked in both of them. So basically, we got a bunch of base, which I'm not going to show you. But I did get this Jalen Hurts House Calls insert out of Snaz's break. So thank you, sir. That's the best card I got. No one really chases the Eagles any fucking more because Jalen Hurts is no longer a rookie. And people are paying for the wide receiver, Devontae Smith, but they're not paying like they were doing Mr. Jalen Hurts. So I did wind up getting a numbered insert card out of $2.99. I'm not sure if this came from Snaz or Eloy. I also got this out of $99. I think this came from Snaz. Actually, I'm pretty sure this came from Snaz's break. And then I was honored enough and lucky enough to get this Devontae Smith out of 10 short print. And this was an Eloy pull. I do remember I got pulled this right after my boy Big Cat got pulled a Joe Burrow card, man. A Joe Burrow insert. So, yep. So that was pretty much the highlight of those breaks I was in. And I didn't get any ink. And I was kind of sucked because I've been in a lot of the player breaks and shit like that. And the breaks just haven't been going too well for me. So I actually backed off of them once again. All right. So that's the stuff I got from Eloy and those player breaks and stuff I mentioned to you. Now, as you see, if I turn the camera that way, that's a pile of stuff I got sitting there that I've picked up over the last 2 weeks. And, of course, I still have more stuff coming in. Alrighty, so let's get into it. Sorry if I'm boring you guys. You know, just typical going through the mail day stuff. I got some nice cards that I picked up. Like I said, not as good as the last video. The last video was fire. I had one of ones. I had shields. I was feeling like I was the man in the last video. You couldn't tell me nothing. I was the man. I was doing big things. I was having autos. I was having shields. I was like, yeah, yeah, yeah. And now this week, I'm like, we had to tone it down a little bit. So I'm back in my little shell, chilling with a little bit of cards that I'm a little bit of fire. Not a lot, but a little bit of fire. So, yeah, you know, I had to tone it down a little bit. By the way, shout out to Yeti and Henso, man. They got a video that's going to be coming of them doing like an epic, when I say epic, an epic break, man. They always pull fire. They got like, shit, they have like a whole couch load of boxes far as, you know, they had Fat Football. I seen, Magic. I seen all kinds of shit, man. They got, like, you name it, they got it, man. And they have been breaking. I'm waiting for this video. When I say a whole couch load, I mean, like, a whole couch. I'm not talking about a love seat. I'm talking about, like, a couch of just product, man. Shout out to them guys, man. Looking forward to the video. If you're not following them, please follow those guys, man. They are the coolest cats in the hobby, man. Glad to call them my brother. Actually, my brothers, I should say, because it's two and not one of them. And real good guys. Will do anything for you. Will look out for you to the fullest, man. So check those guys out. Make sure when they load that video, I'm gonna share that damn thing, cause it's gonna be epic. It's gonna be epic. It's gonna be epic. I promise. So yes, yes, yes. Big Cat, you know it's all love, bro. You know I love you. I love you, Big Cat. Yeah. Meow. All right, guys. Let me get back on track here, man. So I picked up some stuff along the way, as always. Got some nice stuff, man. Nice stuff. So let's start off with Mr. Mike Williams. Mr. Mike Williams... his stuff has been kind of hard to come by, believe it or not. His price has went up. I think it's because they think they're going to be a contender this year. Check that out. Alloy's back home from his national trip. Weekend of turning up. The man of all men, the big kahuna, the captain, the boss, the presidente. But his stuff has went back up. I think because they're saying they're going to be a contender, and he's got a hot QB hitting him off with passes. It's not as easy getting his stuff right now. Every once in a while, I come up on a deal like this. This is actually supposed to be considered like the case hit or box hit, I guess, because this prestige, once again, is what's up, Zach? You just in time, man. I'm about to get into some fire, man. You come in at the right time, man. And I won't be long. Prestige did what they did last year. Basically, their retail is hobby. And they have autos and everything in there. The hero inserts, which I do not like this year. Last year's heroes insert was the shit. This year, I don't think they look that good. Will I take one? Absolutely. But I don't think they look as good as last year. But this is supposed to be the case hit. They call this like the, I don't know what they call this, but it's supposed to be, I did, man. They said he's a hot, meaning playing wise, fool. I am not gay. I am not gay. And he done threw my whole concentration off, man. We're going on to the next card, god damn it. Yeah, man. These heroes are not as good as they were last year, man. Fester, I gotta write your name down, man. I got a list going on. I'm gonna razz you guys off because you came in. For my 100th video giveaway, I'm gonna take two people, I'm going to have a top winner and a bottom winner, and I'm going to get you some stuff for your PC. Fess and Zach, I thank you both for your support. I thanked everybody else, but I thank you guys for your support. Thank you for coming in here and just rocking with me, man. I got everybody's name written down. Of course, I will razz. And I don't know. I might try to squeeze it in at this video. Or I might just do another separate video because it won't matter. I'll do a separate video, do a razz, let y'all see what happened, and go from there. Probably do that so y'all can get back to your normal life and stuff. So I'll let you know if you want or not. But getting back to this, this is a pickup I picked up for like, I think I got this for like $8. This is a short print. This is a nice short print at that. This is a encased, man. A lot of the encased, they actually come encased, but this one was not one. This is a four color patch, man. Nice patches. Got a lot of patches of Mr. Mike Williams, man. And I hope he has a good year. And believe it or not, I actually said something to him on Twitter about a week ago, and I had a nice reply back from Mr. Mike Williams. That's why I collect this mofo. He's a nice dude, man. And underrated. Alright, so let's get into some Eagles. Everything from here on out is going to be Eagles. You know how I do. I'll start base cards, number cards, autos, patches. It gets intense. So we're going to start off with our Super Bowl legend, Mr. Nick Foles. This is like the blue laser. These are not numbered. And this is out of 2018, I believe, Prism. And we're going to follow that up with a Brandon Graham. Next, we got some Fletcher action, which has took over this side PC. In this group I'm in this Super Collectors group. And 250 cards, you can bring your player in, and they'll start keeping track of them. I am at 232 Fletcher Cox cards. And I have, I can't remember how many autos. I think I had 50 autos? 50 autos, I believe. Maybe a little bit more than 50, but I got a lot of Fletcher Cox autos. And I didn't realize it, so I think when I get to 250, I'll be joining him with Dawkins in the Super Collectors group, man. So we're going to start off with the Rookie Impact. This is just the base card. This is not the Prism. Can't find the Prism anywhere. Been looking for it. But it will find its way to me. We will find each other. We have the out of 10 gold of the Rookie Impact. And this is indeed a Prism. And this is number 210. I actually got this from a guy. My guy, I think his name is, I want to say Nate. He's in the Eagles forum page that I'm in. He was selling a bunch of stuff. And I was able to grab a lot of the Fletchers that you would see from him. He gave me a nice solid deal, man. And I got some heat coming, man. I always got heat coming. I just ain't there yet. I picked this up too. This is numbered out of 70. This is Rookies and Stars. This is the red. Nothing really special to talk about this card here. Besides that it hit the count meter. We have this. We have another gold. I got a lot of gold tonight, man. This is from the same guy, Nate. This is the X's and O's. Silent card, man. Short print to 10. I couldn't beat it, man. Contenders Optic, love it. We got the Elite Insert. Elite Series, nothing special here. These inserts are not numbered. We have the Obsidian. This is supposed to be gold to me on the black. It looked kind of greenish. But this is indeed a short print to 10. And this was actually a freebie from my guy Nate that I bought all the stuff from, man. He hooked me up with 2 free cards out of 10. It's always good when someone recognizes that you do a lot of solid business with them and they hook you up with some stuff, man, because he didn't have to do that. And I appreciate that, Nate. We got the Elite, Mr. Fletcher Cox. I told you, Fletcher done took over. He done took over the side PC, man. He done surpassed Mike Williams. Mike Williams, I have 192 cards now, but he surpassed him, man. So we have the Elite Pink Fletcher Cox there. Nothing special, not numbered. Then we have some more gold, man. I'm telling you, gold. We got the gold optic, man. Dunruss optic gold. Of course, you already know when it's gold, it's numbered out of 10. Numbered out of 5 is normally emerald green. So that was a solid pickup. Shout out to my guy, Nate. And shout out to my guy, Nate, again, man. We got the season ticket contenders optic, man. I don't even have to flip this damn thing around. You know it's yellow. It's gold, baby. So it's numbered out of 10. Let's go, man. Let's go. Solid stuff, man. Who shows you good mail days like I do, man? Just because you're not an Eagle fan doesn't mean that I don't have some of the hottest shit to share with y'all every 2 damn weeks. Yes, sir. I love it, man. I love them all, man. And that's just the beginning of contenders, man. We got some more contenders coming along the way, man. But we're going to go here with the score. We have some score. That is this year's. This is last year. This is 2020. This is the artist proof. And this thing is short print to 35, as you can see in that left corner. I'm telling you, man, the Fletchers are ridiculous, man. We also have we have the orange. This is the first down version of Mr. Fletch. And this one is numbered out of 10. So we got a short print there, man. Super short print, man. Speaking of, damn it, contenders, man. We are back with the contender optic. X's and O's, man. This green is so damn pretty, man. This is a beautiful card, man. This is numbered to 27. I know it's not not as short as the gold, man, but it's something about that green, man. That green just looks amazing on these cards, man. I have the Brian Dawkins contender optic auto. And it's green, man. And that damn thing pops, man. And this card really pops, man. The light is not doing this card any justice. It's a damn good looking card, man. All right, so we're about to get into some heat, man. I'm going to push some stuff back. I'm going to save some of the heat for a little later after these two cards. We have your basic 2021 score. Nothing special here. Just a purple border, which I have tons of score. It's cheap, and his cards are going dirt cheap now, so I'm cleaning up while I can before his price goes back up. We have this. We have the Fletcher Cox Blue Explosion. This is a short print to 20. There we go. Camera focus. Last video, I did show you guys the Jason Kelce version of this, but this is the Fletcher. That blue actually pops really nice on this card. Actually, the whole card pops. It's just that you got to be in the right lighting. I'm trying to see if I can get it. You can see a little bit of poppage going on up there. Just a little bit. But the whole card does that. Next, we're going to get into some beauties, man. I got this from my guy, Nate, man. Where I got all the golds from. I've been talking about Nate this, Nate that, Nate this. I really did some damn shopping with Nate. He really looked out for me. This is indeed a rare-ass card. This is the Green Disco, or the Green No Huddle of Mr. Fletcher, man. And this is a super, super, super short print. I'm on the fence about putting this damn thing in a one-touch. I'm thinking about it because it's a nice-looking card, and this thing is numbered to 5, man. And these cards are expensive, and they're hard to get a hold of, man. But I got one, man. Shout out to him, man. And to talk about this same guy I've been talking about all night, hit me off with this. We have the goddamn Fletcher Cox Prism Snakeskin. Let me tell you, man, these snakeskins are hard to get a hold of, man. And I fucking got one. I need to get the Brian Dawkins snakeskin, and I will be good to go. I have the checkerboard or the racing colored flag, whatever you want to call that, the black and white one. But I need the snake skin for Dawkins, man. This is actually a nice card, man. And a lot of people go crazy over these cards. I was fortunate enough to get this for a nice price from my guy, Nate. Thank you, man. Definitely nice pickup, and he looked out on the price, man, because what they list this for on eBay, I did not pay that, not even close. So thank you, sir. I told you guys I had some good stuff, man. I told you guys, and we're almost through it. We got that left. We're almost through it. We're almost there. But of course, you know, it heats up. It always do. So we're still on Fletcher, man. Got a few cards. Well, I got a lot of Fletcher cards, man. We're just gonna start and keep it simple. We're gonna start with the Luminous, man. Luminous base. Nothing special here, nothing to be said. This is just a base card. Just a blah card. But then when you start getting into the numbered cards of it, this is numbered out of 299. It has like around the jersey area, it has like a little pop to it, man. It's like a little foil color, man. Like, if you hit the light right, you can see where it's got like a little prism look, man. But this is, you know, nothing really special here, $2.99. It's limited, but it's still a lot of them out there. Then you start getting down to your blues. This is the same card, of course, numbered to 99, so we're not going to harp on that. Then we got the orange, which is the same card. We're not going to harp on that either. That's just numbered to 50. I can't really show you guys that pop I'm talking about, but it's in there. I promise you. Then we're going to talk about the out of 75, which this was supposed to have been the next card, then the orange one. It kind of got out of order there, but no big deal. This is just your green typical green foil card there, man. Then we go to your teal. We got the out of 35, man. We pretty much have a rainbow started that I'm not intentionally trying to make or build. It just happened like that. A lot of these cards I got for about $2 a piece. And that is the shortest print of that card I have out of 35. And that's a teal. All right, next. Yeah, hey, if the 101 comes, it comes. If not... Hey, man, I'm glad to have you back, man. I still ain't even got to the hot stuff. You're right on time because it's about to heat up in here. I promise you. It's actually about to heat up right now. We're going to go with this, man. Got this for like $12 out of 25. I wasn't going to pay $12 for this damn thing. This is player worn, not game used. But I have the one-of-one shield. I showed that. My last mail day, I have the 101 shield. So it was like, why not try to get the rest of them? So we have this one. I already have the out of 10. I believe I have the out of 5. I need to get the out of 49, out of 99, and I think there's another number, and I'll have a whole damn rainbow. But that is a slick card there. Basically, that's part of the number with a little bit of gray in there, which is so it. All right. So we got Mr. Jason Kels. I'm always going to call you Kelsey, man, because you allowed us to call you Kelsey for these obscene years, man. So Mr. Jason Kelsey, we have a short print of 15, bro. 15. National Treasures, man. One of the higher class cards, I should say. Definitely got this for a steal. I'm happy I got it. Not trying to build the rainbow here or nothing like that, but I do have, I think, the out of 49 of this card. Let's go back to Mr. Fletcher. We have this here. This is another auto. Jesus Christ. This is auto is out of 75. This is what the Back to the Future cards look like in this year's Elite. Not bad, just basically standard. I got this card for about $12. Followed with this one. Passing the Torch, got this card for about, I think, $9 or $10. This one's numbered out of 75. I do think the Passing the Torch look better than the Back to the Future card. But I do know a lot of players that have the Passing of the Torch also have a player in the back with an auto. In this case, Mr. Fletcher does not. So he is actually solo, and this is a short print of 75. Then we go to another auto of Mr. Fletcher Cox, which is the 2018 certified. Yep, I am correct. No, actually, I'm wrong. No, I'm right. 2018 certified. I showed you guys the out of 25 red last video, so we now have the silver. So we're going to go now to... the score, we're back to score. This is a super short print. Out of 6. If this wasn't a scorecard, I would tell you the truth, this would have been in a one-touch. But score, one-touch, I'll save my one-touch. This is the end zone. This is the emerald green. Definitely a nice card. Got this for the low ski. Didn't really pay much for it. I just had to keep my eyes on it, and I went for it, and I wound up getting it. So short print, out of 6. And lastly for Fletcher, then the rest is Mr. Brian Dawkins. We have this. We have the rookie. We have the in-case reserved. This is out of 10, short print. Not your highest grade, but I don't give a damn about the grade because it's staying in the PC. If you guys were with me last week, you would know that I got the out of 50. Not last week, the week before last. So this is an on-card with his number, 91, at the bottom. Definitely a solid pickup. I got this card for about $19, maybe $20. Couldn't resist it. Short print, and it's graded. Staying in the PC. Couldn't beat it. Voila. All right, so lastly, a little bit of cards left in the stack. This is the B. Dawkins. And we're going to breeze through these. I'm going to get you guys out of here. I appreciate you guys putting up with my shit over the years. I appreciate you guys listening to me ramble on about the fire that I'm throwing upon you guys. I'm throwing flames and throwing cards and throwing F-bombs and just throwing. So thank you guys for rocking with me. My guy Henso, turn around. We have Mr. Brian Dawkins. We have the Topps Chrome Refractor. Definitely a beautiful card. Just not in the right uni, my guy Jason would say. Pick this up for a few bucks. We also got the blue chrome, which is numbered to 199, I believe. I am correct. They say this is a refractor. To me, it's more like a prism. But I guess refractor was the word for prism for Topps. Definitely a solid pickup there, man. I paid $3 for that damn card. We got this here. We got the purple 3D with your legends. All Hall of Famers here. My man B Dawk in the middle. I like that. I have them all. I'm just missing the green. None of these are numbered, they're just colored. So they have a red I own, they have the silver I own, they have the gold I own, they have the purple, which I have now, and they have a green somewhere out there. So I just need the green and I'll have the whole set. Whew. All right, we have the first down playoff. Playoff football, I guess that's what you'll call it. Yeah, playoff football. This is number 299. I do have the third down. I'm looking for the fourth down. The fourth down is out of 10. You have the end zone. You have the kickoff. You have the goal line. You have the red zone. I'm missing two. I need the end zone, red zone, and I need the fourth down, and I believe I have them all except the one of one. Moving into some elite. I was in some player breaks with Brian Dawkins, and I wound up striking out. I've got tons of base, which this is one here. As you know, earlier I was throwing his base cards around. I was making it ring with the wax. Wax on, wax off. But this is just the base version. And then we got some color I'm going to show you guys. We got the out of 80. This is the aspirations. There's so many variations of this damn card, man. It's going to take me a while to get the majority of them. We got this one here. This is out of 99. This is the purple. This is like the Devontae Smith that I showed you guys earlier. Then we have, which is my favorite card by far right now, we have the teal, man. And I don't know what they call this. I don't know if they call this pinwheel. I don't know if they call this explosions. I don't know if they call this fireworks. But this is a damn beautiful card in person, man. Like, the light hits this card just right. The whole damn card just lights up, man. Look at the bottom of it. It's a dope card, man. I first seen this card in PC87 video. He actually has one of Jordy like this. And I seen that. I said, I wonder if I'll be able to get a Dawkins one. And I did. I paid about $6 for this. And it is a bookend, 25 of 25, eBay 101, if you believe in that bullshit. But, yeah, solid pickup. We have the status. I was going to say aspirations, but no, we have the status die cut out of 24. Paid a little bit more than I wanted for this, but it is a short print. And I know that, you know, sometime when you let those short print go, you will not see them for a long time, if not ever again. So I did pick this up. And we did get this one as well. This is the out of 10 blue Brian Dawkins Elite. Parallel, nothing special here. Just trimmed in blue. That's all I can say. And lastly, for Elite, we have the out of 10 gold. This will be the first off the line. The minute I seen this posted, which I don't have much of first off the line stuff, I messaged the guy right away and said, look, can we make a deal for this? He hit me off with a good deal, man. So, hey, Bosley, what's up, brother? Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for dropping by, man. You dropped in. I got to put your name down. I'm doing a 100th video giveaway. I don't have any materials to send, so I'm going to get you something for your PC. I'm going to put everyone that's in here tonight in a randomizer, and the top person will get something and the bottom person. And I'm about to add you to the list right now. I'm probably going to come back and do a video later because I've already been on here a long time, especially I had some technical difficulty. So I'll probably do a live stream with me picking these, getting these names picked out. And if you're drawing, man, then I will get you something for your PC, man. Still the Bears, right? If you're one of the ones. Got your name there at the bottom. Of course, it's just, I'm writing fast. I will go through and straighten it up and have everything nice and tight, when I do this randomizer, man. Just, my way of giving back for you guys coming in, supporting me on my big 100th video. If you guys don't do anything else, please go back and check out my intro. I did something completely different. I acted a fool, kind of corny, but funny at the same time. Check that intro out, and I don't care if you don't watch the rest of the video. You should, but if not, you're going to miss some good stuff, man. So my last two cards for the night, we're going to go with the Brian Dawkins Spectra. I've been working on this rainbow for the longest time. He has this card as well. As in the Eagles uni, and there's so many colors of Spectra to get. I'm like halfway done with all of it. He has these, which are just numbered in base. He has the patches, which I almost have all of them. He has the autos, I almost have all of them. I do not remember seeing any autos in the Broncos uni for Spectra, but he does definitely have them for the Eagles. I have quite a few of them, man. Hell yeah, man. Way to kick ass, Ballsley, on your sobriety, man. That is big, man. I'm super proud of you. Sorry I did not mention it. I did see you talk about that on Twitter not too long ago. I hope you keep it going, brother. We are with you. We support you, man. And keep being strong, man. You're a goddamn good guy. A nice guy to talk to. A wonderful person to have around in the hobby, man. You keep being great. Goddamn it. Love you, brother. But my last card of the night would only be right if I ended on the right foot. You know what I mean? Everything right, gotta end the night right on the right foot when you put up a damn Brian Dawkins autograph card, man. This is out of Illusions. I did not have to put this in a one-touch because it came in one already. The seal has not been broke on this damn thing. I got a hell of a deal on this card. This card been going for, it's going more than what it should. This damn card last sold for about $90. I wound up getting this damn thing for $50. A little bit more than I want to pay for it because I know when this shit first came out, before the price jack, this thing was going for like $39 to $40. So I kind of paid a little bit more for it, but I couldn't turn it down because I'm like striving for like the greatest, to be the greatest Dawkins collector there is. I want to be number one. Probably impossible with all the shit he has out here. But I want to be known as the guy that you can say, damn, Eagle Boy 1022 was a goddamn good Dawkins collector, man. Like, he has, like, a lot of his stuff, man. And the Dawkins news I was telling you guys about, this autograph right here makes autograph 82. It makes autograph 82, and I am 9 cards away from having 500. Let me say it again. I am 9 cards away from having 500 unique, different, however you want to say it in any other languages. I have almost 500 different Dawkins cards. My Dawkins count officially as of today is 491 cards. 82 of those cards are autograph cards. Next week, I have an auto coming in. I will be at 83 autos next week. The Dawkins train is rolling, my guys. And a lot of you guys in here have definitely contributed to my Dawkins findings. Some of you guys have sent me Dawkins, you know, out of the kindness of your hearts. You guys have sent me, like, numbered cards, base cards, autographs. I cannot be thankful enough for you guys. I am showing my ugly mug again. It is all good. I'm going to back this up a little bit. I just want to personally thank you guys so much for rocking with your boy. You've been putting up with my shit for a long time. I come on here, I rant and rave. I go on here, I drop F-bombs. I throw cards at y'all like I'm at the strip joint. Throwing wax at you guys, you know, making it rain in this damn place. Woo! Making it rain! Making it rain! Making it rain! But I could not, definitely could not do this without you guys, man. I'm looking forward to, I really, really, really wish that I could meet all of you guys at one time. Like, you know, I'm me. The same way I act on here, I'm going to act in person. I'm a fool. It don't take me long to warm up to people. I'm just a people's person. You know, like I said, F Nationals happen next year, as it should. I know in my area, unfortunately, COVID is, the numbers are going up pretty high where I am. So I'm just right now trying to stay safe, collect cards, and do everything I can to keep my family safe and happy. But, you know, hopefully I can meet you guys. Definitely. I'm so grateful. I'm sorry to keep saying the same thing. And I would turn my camera around, but I know with the internet and everything, I don't want to bother it. My camera is actually turned this way. So if you guys have an iPhone, my camera is actually sideways. So sorry, you got to see my ugly mug, not straight. But I really, 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 from the bottom of my heart, man, I appreciate the support. I definitely, definitely appreciate the support. I don't feel I get the views I should. I know nobody really don't want to see nobody opening Eagle stuff all the time. But that's just who I collect. You know, I don't have access to doing the rip and chills like that anymore. Because, like, you know, the rules with getting retail at Target and our Walmart does not do cards anymore. I still got some wax packs. Shout out to Jason. He sent me like months ago, and I have not, still have not opened the stuff up. It's just junk wax, but it's still something to do, still something to share with you guys. I just can't get no product in, man. So all I can do right now are these mail days, man. And I get some amazing stuff, man. And I promise you, I will try to. For anyone that do videos, I always watch the videos. Even if I don't watch it the same day it comes out, I always watch your videos. And I always try to leave a comment so you know I was there. But like I said, I do have you guys' names on a page, on this little card here. Shout out to Eloy. He sent 1,000 of these damn cards, so I used his card to write your names on. I want to get back to y'all. So I definitely thank you, Zach. I appreciate that, brother. You know, and you were like one of the first people that I met in the hobby, along with Chris and Matt and Coker and Sarah. And, you know, it's just, I just, y'all like my day one fan, man. And then everybody else came along. I'm just thankful, man. I'm thankful that y'all still like rocking with me. I've grown a lot. If you go back and look at some of the videos and look at some of the stuff I was bringing in, you would know that I was just getting stuff. The Eagles, bring it. But now I know how I want my stuff, man. And everything is nice and organized. And I'm just happy, man. I'm just happy. Just straight up legitly happy. I mean, it's people like y'all that make this hobby so good. There's times I get down on this hobby, especially when it comes to the pricing of the stuff and you're not being able to get... I mean, when did it come hard to get retail? Like, that shit blows my mind. Like, it's retail. So, yes. So, I done rambling on. Sweet, man. Hey, man. Sweet. If you send it, I appreciate it. You don't have to rush it, you know, because I still got all those glasses that you sent me, and that you send me the glasses, and you send me a figurine, and you sent me a piggy bank, which I gave to my son, and that damn thing's almost full. It has paper money in there. It has coins in there. So thank you for that, brother. My son loves that piggy bank, and he's been using it. Every time we have change laying around, if he can remember, he puts change in it. The blanket, I still have that thing. I washed it. It kind of fell apart, so I got it sitting in the box with your name on it, along with my, site beside my jerseys. So, yes, the cups are in my cabinet. I actually drank out of two of them. The other two, I haven't drank out of yet. So, yes, I have all that stuff, man. But, like I said, thank you guys so much for the support. I'm going to get these names in a randomizer either tonight or tomorrow. Either way, it's like I send y'all shit anyway. So it's really not like I'm going out my way. But I just... Hey, what's going on, man? I just want to just give back, man, and just say thank you. Because you guys are spending your Sunday evening with me. There's a zillion things you could be doing. You could be get ready for work, which I unfortunately go back to work tomorrow. I've been home for 3 months, and I got to get back to work. Superman's got to go back in the building. I don't want to. You know, I am a supervisor, so when I go back to work, I'm going to have a whole lot of shit to deal with that I don't want to. But I'm going back... those that know my situation, I'm actually feeling better. I still have a little bit of pain here and there, but I'm better than what I was, and it's time to get back to work. I've been out for 3 months. I still got time left, but it's cutting it a little close to being depleted. So we got to go back, got to try to make up, get some overtime, get some of that time back, and see what we can do, man. But yeah, so it's going to suck. Tomorrow's probably going to drag. I'm going to be in a bad mood because I've been home, and then you got to go get up early. Got to go get in this damn work truck and put on these heavy boots and all this shit. So not looking forward to that. But it is what it is. So I actually get to end the night doing something I love. I love sharing, beautiful things with you guys. I know I'm rambling, man, but I'm just so goddamn appreciative, man. Like, you guys don't have to be here. And you guys come in, same people, week after week after week after week after week. Just to support my ass. I appreciate that shit. I really do. I'm about to get out of here. Like I said, if you didn't catch the beginning of it, go check out my intro. It's something corny, but I just figured it fit the mood. Man, I appreciate y'all, man. But check that intro out, man. It's corny as hell, but I had fun doing it. Like I said, I will. You'll see me go live when I do this this randomizer. Like I said, it's no big deal. Sorry I couldn't give you guys, you know, like the big rollers do. They send you supplies and hobby boxes and packs. I just don't have access to that. So why not just cut to the chase and get you something I know that you would like for your PC. Something I know you would cherish. And if I sent you ever anything ever, you guys know I don't send you a bunch of base cards. I don't do it. I send you stuff that I hope that you don't have, numbered, patched. And if I can squeeze in an auto at the right price, I definitely will. If not, I will load you up with patches and number cards, man. But until then, thank you, Fester. I appreciate it, man. Thank you for your support, man. You've been here every week, damn near. Couldn't thank you enough. Never met you in person, but I can damn sure tell that you're a loyal, stand-up guy, man. And I appreciate that shit. Hobby needs more people like you guys, man. I love you all. Thank you for putting up with my Mike Williams collection, the Brian Dawkins collection, the Fletcher Cox collection, the new Brandon Graham collection, the new Jason Kelsey, collection, and whatever else comes, man. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your Sunday. If you guys working tomorrow, be safe. If it's hot, because it's hot here, plenty of fluids. We'd love to see you guys back again soon. Love you guys. Mwah! Take a bow. And if I had a skirt on, I'll swat a little bit, you know. No one wants to see my Mariota. That's bullshit. I like looking at your stuff, man. You haven't did a video in a while. Actually, the last time I seen you on social media, actually video-wise, you was with Rippin' Gypsy. And I was in there. I came in there because you were there. I don't get in there often, but I know there's a familiar face that's in there. And you were live, so I came. And your daughter was pulling nothing but fire out of those jerseys. So that shows that I was really in there. And I stayed in there for a while. I didn't just pop in and leave. She pulled some fire jerseys and wanted to pull more. And then I left. So, thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. Okay. But yeah, thank you guys. I'm out, man. Be safe. Peace. Hold up. Should I do it leaving? Hold on. Let's do it right. Let's leave right. I'm swimming and I can't swim.